Hello everybody and welcome to another one of our leadership training videos. Now by now, I hope that you know that in these leadership training videos, I talk about how to become a better leader, how to become a leader if you're not a leader already, how to become more effective in your leadership, what the leadership traits, skills and qualities are that you need, and of course, how to train and develop yourself as a leader. But to clarify, it's not just about leadership in terms of corporate leadership, it's leadership in terms of your own entrepreneurial journey. If you have your own business, you run your own company, or maybe even in life where you are a member of the family and there's a responsibility that you have, many of these aspects are just as appropriate in your private life as they are in your business life. My name is Chris Igwe. I have over 35 years experience leading, training and developing teams across five major markets in Europe, but also Europe, Middle East and Africa, where I have had teams and of course have done a lot of business. So I want to welcome you to this particular leadership training video. And in this one, we're going to talk about something which is so current. It is just, none of us can escape it. Unless you're living on an island, you've got no internet and you have no desire whatsoever to connect with this. But it's a very important topic, which is social media. So what I want to share with you is some thoughts and ideas to consider and things to avoid in terms of your own leadership journey. So the first thing I want to just explain is that in order to be a leader in the social media environment, you have to look at it very clearly. And very clearly means you have to see it as an opportunity to influence and inspire. Remember, leadership is about inspiring people. It's about influencing people as well in a positive manner. So this is a great opportunity in the social media space, which we see more and more today, to influence and inspire. And in my case, I have the privilege of being described as a global thought leader within not only the retail and retail real estate industry, but because I go beyond that, and obviously these videos are part of it in terms of leadership. So social media is very important, but as a leader, you need to consider these various platforms. Now, depending on where you are and what you use and where you are in your own journey, these are the main ones. So you've got LinkedIn, you've got Twitter, you've got Facebook, but I'm specific Facebook business. In other words, driving your business in some way, shape or form. Instagram and the newest kid on the block that's very successful is TikTok. Now, whichever one you use or combination thereof, it's very important that you make some very clear determinations about not only how you want to use it, who you want to target and what you want to say. Now for my approach, I normally use predominantly LinkedIn, Instagram and Twitter, less Facebook business, and I haven't got onto TikTok yet, although people recommend that I do so, and I will eventually, but within these platforms, because I have my own website as well, so inevitably there's a lot to manage. But the question is, how do you approach each of these? And I'm going to give you just one very quick example. So for example, with Instagram, a few years ago, I started out basically sharing with people my retail images, the photos and whatever that I took. And on one occasion, somebody said to me in the post that I did, which was about the new Canada Goose store on Regent Street in London, they were in the throes of the fact that the product used by Canada Goose and the ethics and all the rest of it was not what they wanted to see. So the person came into my space, didn't know them, they weren't part of my group as it were, and basically said that I should take the photo down, it was unacceptable and so on and so forth. Now there are two ways you can approach this. You can imagine you can either block the person, lock them out, engage in some sort of tirade between the two of you. But I simply said, listen, this is my space. If you wish to be a part of this conversation, you are welcome to. However, there are two things that I want. One is respect for me and my space, and the second is the respect for other people's comments, just as yours. If you wish to stay and contribute, please do so. If you don't, then please step out. I didn't hear from him again, or her, I don't know which it was. Doesn't really matter, but the point is, what I'm trying to get across to you are these considerations here. which is that whatever you do, firstly, you have to show up, but you have to show up with integrity. That example that I made, I could have been pretty nasty about it. I could have been very protective. I could have gone off in many different directions, but that's not the purpose of the way that I use social media, or indeed the way I wish to communicate. But when you communicate within social media, make sure that not only do you do so with integrity, but you make sure that you're contributing in terms of content. You're contributing in terms of stories or sharing of information, sharing of knowledge. Because all of this is all part of your own leadership journey. You want to show that when you show up, you A, have something to tell and share, B, you are very confident and comfortable in what you are sharing, and in some way, shape or form, you are actually contributing to a conversation. So it's very important that you share knowledge and you provide content. Those for me are the two main things you should be doing, and stories where they help. Now, inevitably here, I might be talking about where you're sharing on your own platform. In other words, that's what you're putting out. But don't forget that in sharing, you make comments on other people's posts, images, whatever it is you want to use. And that is the key, is the fact that you can turn up, you can engage, you can connect, you can communicate with other people. It doesn't have to be a long story. It could just be a comment or an idea or a thought that you share in that particular space. Now, here are the red flags. They will come as no surprise, but it's amazing the number of people who I see and know, because they're either part of my community or I can tell from their profile, that they are senior individuals in an industry, or they know very deeply that topic or that subject. And yet, they get into the aggressive mode. So there's aggression through the words that are used. There's anger through the words that are used. And it doesn't have to be anger on some sort of geopolitical level. It could just be on a topic that someone has shared and you disagree with. Avoid ranting. Ranting demeans you completely. It shows that you're just a nut job at the end of the day, because you're not communicating in a constructive, informative, sharing manner. And avoid, most of all, negative words and, of course, swear words as well. All these here and many more, you can make quite a long list of them, and I've seen them all, is to really take yourself from wherever you are or you're sitting position-wise to a much lower level. Someone like me would lose trust, confidence, and appreciation for you if any of this is what I was seeing. You can be firm and affirmative, but there's a way in which you do it. So you can do it with different words. And then I guess just in closing, I would say for me, these are the areas I avoid, and I would encourage you to find which ones they are that are no-go area for you on a global or visible platform. The ones, which will come as no surprise to you, I do not engage in any conversation on social media around religion. I'm a Christian, I go to church, but I would never put that out there as a reason to engage in some sort of a conversation or communication around the subject. Politics. I absolutely avoid politics in any way, shape, or form. I may read something, I may be interested in something, but I neither like nor comment, because that's just not the space I choose to be in. I don't talk about sex or engage in any sex conversation, and I mean sex more in the context of the LGBTQ community, whether it's same sex attraction. In our church, for example, recently we've done a 5-week program looking at same sex within the church, what it means, what it's about. There are things I don't understand. There are things I may never understand. There are things I accept. There are things that I don't accept. But all those are my own private business. And by the way, all of this I will discuss offline with close friends or individuals or someone who wants to engage in an intelligent, constructive conversation with me. I will do it, but I wouldn't do it on social media. And of course, the final one of this is ethnicity. It could be Black Lives Matter and that whole thing. Clearly I'm black, so I have a view, I have a position, I have a desire for the conversation to move forward, but I would never do so in an open forum platform. Why? For the very simple reason, amongst many, but for the very simple reason, and I suggest you take this to heart, It absorbs your energy. It takes your time, both of which are incredibly valuable. You cannot allow your time to be usurped by a conversation that is probably going to go nowhere, because it's very difficult to reach agreement on a social media platform around anything. Even if you get 100 people that like your comment on LinkedIn, for example, that does not mean that you are right. You will still have a few that will lambast you, will be unhappy, and whatever. If that's what you want to do, that's totally okay. I will not and do not spend my time on social media engaging in areas which I think are provocative and inappropriate. I would rather DM the person, text the person, email the person if I know who they are, and I might have a conversation. But even then, what is the objective of that conversation? Because time is the one resource amongst many today, but it's the one resource you cannot recover if you lose it. So what are the reasons for you doing that? So these are just some of the thoughts around social media. Very, very important to be in the social media space as a leader, but communicate, connect, comment on, offer insights and experience based on your area of expertise, because you want to elevate the conversation. So I'm not saying by any stretch, don't do social media, do it, but do it very clearly. I've been able to develop my social media skills and abilities, and I know that a lot of people very much enjoy at least observing many of them in the background. They may not like or comment or share, but they have said to me that what I share is insightful, it influences their thoughts, I share new ideas, it inspires them, and they want to see more. If you can achieve that sort of level, and I mean in a professional environment, whatever you do privately, whether it's obviously WhatsApp or Facebook or whatever, that's entirely up to you. But within a professional environment, as a leader, it could be a private environment, but professionally, you want to be seen as the reference in your particular area and grow your leadership, because that's what this is all about, is growing your leadership skills and abilities. And I hope that through my sharing that has helped you. So thank you for listening and watching. I appreciate you being here. And if I may suggest, please feel free to share, like, or comment, and subscribe to the channel so you know when other videos are becoming available. And so until the next time, thank you.